2018 was not the year that larger-than-life characters played by megawatt superstars dominated the screen. Even Shah Rukh Khan went pint-sized this year. Aside from a few towering characters that commanded the screen, 2018 might well have been the year of the everyman. Some of Bollywood's most talented actors brought to life ordinary men who found themselves in extraordinary situations.
Let's do one more.
Ayushman Khurana slipped under the skin of a blind pianist who becomes embroiled in a murder in Andhadhun, channeling the character's helplessness and desperation with great feeling. In Badhai Ho, as the grown-up son of middle-aged parents who become pregnant, he conveyed the embarrassment and the awkwardness of the scenario authentically. Rajkumar Rao brought his signature vulnerability and understated charm to the role of a sweet, ambitious, small-town tailor who becomes smitten with a mysterious young woman in Stri. In the same film, a deliciously droll Pankaj Tripathi delivered big laughs in the littlest of moments, playing a local bookstore owner and know-it-all.
Baby, change kar li tu?
Vicky Kaushal made his every moment count in the role of the protagonist's faithful best friend in Sanju, delivering an affecting performance that felt entirely real.
What's your bag, guys?
In Man Marziyan, he got into the head and the heart of an immature wannabe musician confused about the meaning of love. An everyman, however, is hardly the word you'd use to describe Alauddin Khilji. Ranveer Singh was both magnetic and repulsive as the savage ruler in Padmavat. A portrait of debauchery, the actor pulled no punches in his construction of a man that was the embodiment of extreme evil. The five actors who delivered some of the best performances this year shared their views on the craft of immersion and explained why they don't often discuss acting with their colleagues. They spoke about the changing landscape of Bollywood, the impact of the Me Too movement, and the character from history that they'd like to play when they sat down for the Actors' Roundtable.
Gentlemen, every now and then you get these amazing opportunities to play a role that allows you to completely vanish into a character. One looks at the performance and there is almost no trace of the actor. What you see is just the character. I want to ask you, when you're that deep into a character, when you're immersed that deep into a character, does the camera disappear for you?
I think camera disappears otherwise also. Like personally, I can talk about myself. If I'm really conscious about camera, where it's placed. My directors have this major problem with me that they say, facing they are.
Correct.
And I just can't, you know, act for the camera. I'm acting for my co-actors, I'm acting for the situation. So for me, it is a big issue. I don't know if it's right or wrong, but that's how I see it. I'm not really...
Yaar, mujhe tere saath picture karni hai. Apne co-actors ke liye act karta hai.
No, that's the whole point.
Karta it, cues itne acche deta hai. Main kaam kar chuka hu uske saath. Itne dil se kyun deta ho?
I act better when I'm giving cues. Yeah, all else, I swear. Yeah.
It just so happens. Sometimes the camera is not on you and you're just doing better. You're like, damn, wish I could have done this.
Your OS shots are always better.
Yeah.
For me, it was a little difficult because different initially because I was an anchor. I was talking to the camera and suddenly I was ignoring the camera.
Right.
Two different crafts altogether. Yeah. But yeah, I think you have to be like completely oblivious of the fact that camera's around. You are immersed in your character. And you live the character for that part.
That's true. Huh? It's like opposite ends of the spectrum. Yeah. One is like completely breaking the fourth wall into camera all
Absolutely.
The time for the camera. And then now you're in a place where you have to completely forget about it. Yeah, you can also do films like Befikre, which will flop. Then you can vanish into oblivion also. For 1 year, at least. till Padmavat comes.
That's right.
You know, then you can vanish into the character. But yeah, the material also is so critical, right? It should have that much meat in it and give you that much where you can actually do that. Not every character can offer that. And as an actor, you want to, you know, pump it with your own characterization. Mm. Sometimes it's not forthcoming, so it's a struggle to kind of inject it with that. But then there are parts like Khilji, you know, you can really have fun with it. There's a lot you can do with it.
Sir, मैं रणवीर के उस पे टी-शर्ट पे एक चीता बना हुआ है।
अरे यार।
तो अब I am trying to be like चीता।
Yeah.
कि डॉक्यूमेंट्री जब बनाने जंगल में जाते हैं तो चीता को पता नहीं होता है कि मैं कैमरे के लिए कर रहा हूँ। वो अपनी ज़िंदगी जी रहा होता है।
क्या बात है?
अरे रे।
क्या बात है?
तो मैं ट्राई तो चीता भी पीता है।
जंगल से याद आया यार, फ्लाइट पे मैंने न्यूटन देखी यार। ओ यार तुम लोग यार यार
थोड़ा लेट देखा आपने?
हाँ, एक साल लेट देख लिया आपने।
थोड़ा लेट
बस एक साल
देर है दुरुस्त है देखा क्या? अरे चुम्मा
इनक्रेडिबल ना देखिंग।
आई गेस आई एम समवेयर देयर अवेयर एंड आल्सो नॉट अवेयर समवेयर आई डोंट नो that technical knowledge is there, that you know that the camera
correct
is
how
here.
Because it is still a technical job, isn't it?
Yeah.
Keep yes. your, you know, stick to your mark, yeah. you can't yes, forget yes. your lines, yeah. you have so to know
that,
where to turn.
That comes subconsciously, but at the same time, you are also immersed in your character, in what your co-actor is giving to you, what your location is giving to you, what the props are giving to you, everything. So I think it's somewhere in the middle.
It's not exactly technical, honestly. I think it's about dealing with the emotions. You can't, like for me, a good shot is when I'm not, when there is no second thought in my mind when I'm giving a shot.
True.
If I'm thinking about, okay, oh fuck, look at his hair is not right, and I'm doing an emotional scene, that means it's not true. I'm not there.
Right. तुझे भी होता है कमाल है यार.
That's an example.
But yeah, the best shots are when you're completely lost in the moment. Like when someone calls cut, you're like, oh, you know. That's those are the best ones.
You add a bit of yourself also in the character. It's not always you're playing a character. Like for Badai Ho, I was part of that character. Andhadhun is completely different. Though again, musicality was part of me, but you add a bit of yourself also to the character.
Badhai ho ke liye badhai ho. Aap mujhe bhi bol sakte hain badhai ho.
Arre badhai ho,
badhai ho. Thank you.
Naye dulhe raja aate hain.
Dulhan
jo jayegi dulhe raja ke saath.
Jhulle lal, jhulle lal.
How many days into a shoot does it usually take you to find the character? Was there a role, one role that was harder than others or that took longer than others to just crack the character?
For me, it was Raman Raghav. Playing Raghav in Raman Raghav, it took a bit of a time. And especially because I remember the first day of shoot where we were shooting the interrogation scene with Nawaz Bhai. And all I had to do was just stand. There were no lines, nothing. And I had a scene after that, after lunchtime. And Anurag sir had said, ki yaar, tu soke mat aana. So I didn't sleep for 32 hours. Chala gaya. और उसके बाद में टिल लंच टाइम आई वॉज ग्रेट आई वॉज लाइक ओके कुछ शायद पता नहीं एंड आफ्टर लंच आई हैड लंच एंड आफ्टर लंच टाइम आई वॉज जस्ट आउट आई वॉज ब्लैंक आई वॉज जस्ट आई डोंट नो व्हाट हैपेंड टू मी आई वॉज जस्ट आई ब्लैक्ड आउट आई वॉज लाइक आई टोल्ड अनुराग सर कि सर मैं सो के आ जाऊंगा एक्टिंग पे मेहनत कर लूंगा पर सोने दो
सही बोल रहा है
ये पहला
यार बिना नींद के कुछ नहीं हो सकता
नहीं हो सकता बट एज अ कैरेक्टर ऑल्सो दैट कैरेक्टर took me a bit of time. I mean, took Anurag sir to really push me to a different plane, a different plateau. Yeah.
The first time I'm seeing a director encouraging this kind of crazy behavior.
Right.
You know, they're always trying to protect you invariably.
अच्छे से सो के आना.
That's the first. Huh?
For me, it's like sleeping, eating, acting, and singing in that order.
फिर से?
बिना नींद, eat, sleeping, eating, acting, singing. ये passions हैं life के.
क्या बात?
बिना नींद के कुछ नहीं हो सकता. You have to sleep for 8 hours and then. Go on set, you know, everything. But सोने का भी रोल करना हो ना तो सोना जरूरी है उसके.
रणबीर तो इतना सोना भी पहन के आया है.
Exactly. Pure gold.
सब बाड़े का है.
It happened during Trapped. I think Trapped was a very organic film. It was like I prepared a little bit about the character, but it was I thought I can't really prepare. How would I feel if I don't eat for 10 days? It had to be very organic. So I just let myself be. I just thought everything would happen in the moment. Yeah, you saw it, of course. Yeah,
hit the ground running. Like you just
you just have to living yourself go and then react to the situation. So I almost like stopped eating during that period, and I think that happened after like 3-4 days when your body started reacting to not having food and water. You feel irritated, angry.
Yeah,
I think it happened
from there I started getting the heck off, you know, being shot. Yeah.
For me, it was Andhadhun. Because there was no reference point in real life. I did not know anybody who was pretending to be blind and was a musician. So there was no reference. So I met a lot of blind students in Worli, blind school. And also there was a blind musician, Rahul. I got in touch with him. We had like 2 months extensive workshop for piano also. And also to just imbibe the body language of a blind guy. So that was the most difficult part. But
it was a very
fun.
Tricky part. Huh?
Very tricky, yeah.
Play a character who's pretending to be blind.
And then you learning piano. And you don't have to see it. You piano bajana. It's all the more crazy.
Mujhe sir, at least beginning ke 2-3 days. मैं समझ नहीं पाता हूँ मैं चला जाता हूँ कर रहा होता हूँ और मुझे पता है एक आउटर दुनिया पता है इस किरदार का कि ये ऐसा है इसकी हिस्ट्री ये है इसका बिहेवियर ऐसा होगा बट करूँगा कैसे ये मालूम नहीं होता है और 2 दिन बाद ना या 3rd दिन से मुझे वो किरदार गाइड करने लगता है लगता कि यार ये शेप ले रहा है या ऐसा कुछ बन रहा है जैसे अभी सतीश जी की फिल्म कर रहा था तो 3 दिन बाद मुझे समझ में आया कि अच्छा बॉस ये थोड़ी फिजिकलिटी मांग रहा है तो मुझे दूसरे तीसरे दिन ना सुर समझ में आने लगता है
बट इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल मोमेंट वो जब कैरेक्टर आपको बताना शुरू करता
है वो बताना शुरू करता है कि बॉस मुझे ऐसे
फेज इन फिल्म मेकिंग एंड देन यू समटाइम्स फील कि यार पहले दिन अब वापस कर सकते हैं
ये कैसे कर सकते हैं
नाउ आई नो इट
कि आप समझ में आई
बॉल मिडल होने शुरू हो जाती है
That's happened though. Yeah. That's happened. Rohit sir was telling me that he has gone back once the sur, as they call it, एक बार सुर पड़ जाता है he has actually gone back and shot the first 4-7 days of his films just because at some point his cast got it
it's also the director I think
yeah
they're also finding their sur
yeah
and no way
for me also I think it's a function of over preparing myself I do more like out of just maybe to cope with nerves or I don't know what it is but I prepare a lot I do a lot of homework and then I'll invariably end up in the first 3 days 4 days 7 days doing too much you know and most of them are trappings you can't sustain that for the entire performance so then when it finally hits you then you're like okay I should cut this I don't need to do this yes, I don't need to do this and then you stick with only what works
does that happen pretty much every time
yeah more or less not in the lighter parts are much simpler honestly these lighter films urban films you know they are in all honesty I'll admit to you they're easier to play you know
because that's
at
you.
Least for me yeah.
He's an urban guy.
Yeah, I mean, like, there's not much you have to do, you know, in terms of pumping it with characterization and those the decoration and the frills and they're simpler. But the other ones, it's like you do all the homework and then imagine just writing it all down and then you crush it and you leave it and you throw it away and only what. Is relevant will stay.
Sometimes you just leave that blank space in your head, that blank canvas for the director to fill in.
Yeah.
At times you just over prepare, go on the set with a preconceived notion, and then you suddenly, okay, off balance, that milieu is not, you're probably not on the same page. You go to that place and then let the director come in, and then you on this discover that congruent area between you and the director. So I think that's the.
Yeah. And it's nerve wracking. The first few days are nerve wracking because you're so desperate for that validation for him to say that, him or her to say that, yes, you're doing it right. You're just like desperately seeking that. And like a few days into the schedule, into the first schedule, you'll kind of get comfortable.
Do you often talk to your co-stars or other actors about your process? About the acting, or are most conversations usually about the business and other things? Have you sat down with an actor and had a real conversation about finding your character, about your process, about your approach?
Has that happened? It depends the kind of co-actor you're working with. You know, there are co-actors which probably would you just gel with and chill out with, and then they're like when I shot with Amir sir during my early days in Talash, I actually had like a 3 hours class with him where I was asking about all his. Different characters, the preparations, like he, and he was very kind. He was telling me in detail about how he prepared for Lagaan or for Rang De Basanti or Three Idiots. So it depends, like who are you sitting with and you want to like talk about. I love talking about acting and performances. That's actually my favorite thing to do. But it depends, like because Samne Wale ko bhi interest hona chahiye na, aap se bole ja rahe
hain. Bilkul yaar, most of my conversations are just gossip. I would like to talk about the craft and learn and there should be a give and take, but this is all just gossip. But तलाश से याद आया भाई वो सीन यार when Amir and Rani were talking how oh my god That's, I saw you from a mile out. I was like, this guy.
Thank you. And you're too sweet, Ranveer. Yeah.
हाँ सर मैं करता हूँ बट हाँ सेम टाइम जो राज से मैं सहमत हूँ कि कोई एक्टर या कोई दूसरा साथी चाहे उस पर बात करना तो मेरे पास तो वैसे ही मुझे लगता है बहुत ज्ञानी व्यक्ति हूँ हालांकि ये सबको लगता है हमको हम सब ज्ञानी हैं बट नहीं मैं करता हूँ जिसकी इच्छा हुई या जिसने चाहा अब कई बार उसमें तय होते हैं कि यार हाँ मतलब मैं अपना अनुभव साझा करता हूँ कि मेरे जितने अनुभव हैं उसके अकॉर्डिंग तो बात तो होती है
बात होती है डिपेंड करता है राज ने बोला इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द योर इक्वेशन विद द को एक्टर प्रोबब्ली लाइक वी वर चिलिंग ऑन बरेली की बर्फी वी डिड नॉट डिस्कस
फनी एंटरटेनिंग फिल्म्स
द प्रोसेस बट एवरीबॉडी इज डिफरेंट लाइक फॉर बधाई हो आई थिंक वी ऑल वेरी सिमिलर इन अ वे नोबडी वाज लाइक अ मेथड एक्टर इन अ वे माय मेथड चेंज्ड ओवर द इयर्स आई यूज्ड टू बी अ मेथड एक्टर आई यूज्ड टू डू थिएटर देयर वाज दिस प्री प्रोडक्शन यू हैड टू डू वर्कशॉप्स देन आफ्टर फिफ्थ और सिक्स्थ performance, then you discover that sweet spot. But filming is so different. Like, I after becoming an RJ and anchor, I became more spontaneous as an actor rather than being a method actor. So I could only talk about my craft, change the metamorphosis behind it. But I think I've met actors who are still method actors, like Anu Kapoor is a method actor. Gajraj Rao is a natural actor. Surekha Sikri is a method actor. Neena Gupta is a natural actor. So there you go.
Same. In my initial years, in fact, I got this feedback from Manish Sharma and Vikramaditya Motwani. They were like, brother, you're too rigid in your ways. You know, I don't know why you're preparing so much. You're preparing to a point where you're becoming rigid. And it's becoming hard for us to undo what you've thought about how to play this. I guess I do it just to cope with the nerves. But then in those initial years, I used to just be too rigid and I completely changed, I think, after Ram Leela, because Bhansali, what he'll do, he'll throw you in the deep end. So you either adapt, sink or swim. It's right. Like that. So after that, I think I've come to believe now that the best performances are the ones that happen spontaneously. You know, when you only have to say what you have to say once and it just you don't think it can get better than that one time.
Very few times. I don't know why, but firstly, I feel whatever approach an actor takes for that particular character that he's playing, I feel it's very personal, it's very private, and it's very sacred.
Right.
So asking him about it, I feel like I'm disturbing his space, which I don't like to do. I love to observe it. I love to see the change as to how he is off the set and how he is when he's playing that character. And maybe when you hit that note as co-actors, that's when you kind of ask or you don't ask. But I really, I don't know, very rarely that we've gone into discussions like, you know, because I myself also don't like to put into words as to how I'm, you know, approaching this character. Because I also don't know. I also don't know how to put it into words. Right. I'm just kind of getting to know myself and kind of just feeling it, you know. I can't put into words as to what I'm doing for this character.
It also depends on the director, I think. Like, you probably shift gears with the director also. Like somebody like Shujit Sarkar is very natural. After giving 2-3 takes, I was the one who used to be more hungry or anxious. Ki sir, ek aur. Ek aur karega to overacting karega. So he was different. Like somebody like Amit, he's a perfectionist. You need a certain method. He wanted me to be different from earlier films. So it depends on the director also. You can probably change the process here and there with the director.
I don't even like talking on set, man. I just want to concern myself with the work. It's like we have these 12 hours and we have to make the most of it. I just don't want to converse, conserve my energy and just like focus on the work.
Really?
Honestly.
I agree. Like I like discussions, but till a point. You know, right. I can't have like 2 hours of discussion over a simple scene. I think it's for me, acting is to do, man. Let's explore. Let's explore it on set.
I just remembered because I find myself diverting, you know, avoiding talking. I can see a co-actor coming to have a conversation with me and I'll just shift my gear so that I'll just, you know, just like duck them in a way.
And I am the one who's a disruptor out there.
You're the one who's coming.
I'm the one who's coming. Not with the discussion related to the character or the script.
Right.
Just to chat. Gaana sun lete hain, ye kar lete hain, khana kha lete hain. I'm the one who's like always diverging. I don't know. Digressing.
No, sometimes also what happens is you're playing a character where you feel that there's a need that you have to keep your cards very close to your chest for your co-actors, for the betterment of the scene. That sometimes what happens is
it'll be nice if the co-actors don't know what your energy is.
Yeah.
What they don't know what my sur is. You know, that's just required. That's a requirement.
That happened in City Lights actually with me. With Manav, like we were playing two important characters and somebody was, they were together throughout. And Manav, I remember, like, we thought, like, he said, okay, you know, let's discuss about and let's talk about. I said, but Manav, don't, let's not talk about it at all. Because you don't know me, who am I? This guy has come from Rajasthan. Yeah. You have no idea about him. Yeah. I don't want to tell you about my life. You see me for the first time in the scene. And then only you realize, okay, this guy is this. Right. Because you, how would you know me? Yeah.
Top.
No point. Yeah.
Top.
You know, I was watching the Actors Roundtable that the Hollywood Reporter does, and there was something interesting I came across. Chadwick Boseman, who played the lead in Black Panther, he said about acting, it's not always the glitz and glamour that people think it is. It's really a blue-collar job. You work overtime, you sweat, you get hurt, you're an athlete, you're everything that is necessary. Then Mahershala Ali, who won the Oscar for Moonlight, he added that people don't talk about the workman-like qualities and how you only act between action and cut. It's just 10% of the time. He said the rest is looking for material, prepping for it, the wardrobe, the costume elements, building the psychology. Getting to act is such a minuscule part of the experience that you have to really love it. Is that something you can relate to?
Of course. Yeah. It is about what you do from 5 to 9, not between 9 to 5. You know, it is that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Says this nocturnal creature who's in full bloom at 1 a.m.
I think at the same time, acting cannot be your life. You need to concentrate on your life and live life, get references from your life so that you incorporate those incidents on the celluloid. Acting cannot be your life. I firmly believe that it is more than that. And life, you have to live life to become a better actor.
I think that's right, because I've really started valuing that time that I get on set to perform, you know, which is why I just want to be on the film set the whole time. At least we're there in the thick, it's game time, you know, at least it's like action. It's like at the actual work, the core is happening, it's underway. You know, all the, my downtime, it's getting increasingly difficult to deal with. I really don't know what to do with myself. I'm going through a phase where I just want to be on the film set.
No, I agree with him, but then there are performances, there are characters sometimes, like, of course, like, I don't know, but I'm sure Daniel Day-Lewis won't agree with that, because he's somebody who just been
right,
that character throughout.
Yeah.
For him, it's not just between action and cut. You know, you're constantly otherwise thinking about something, think about that scene. Subconsciously, you're there, you're still there, you're still preparing for your character. Not planning it, how to do it, but still, you know, living it. Like it happened with me during Omerta. Like, it was not only about action and cut. I think for the first time I was so immersed in a character that it just started bothering me personally on a very personal level.
Yeah, it was stunning in that film.
ये बड़ा योगिक काम है. योगिक मतलब समझ रहे हैं ना, साधु वाला, संत वाला, कि आप same time एक actor during the shot perform कर रहा होता है, उसी वक्त
witness भी कर,
उसी का दूसरा witness भी कर रहा होता है, guide भी कर रहा होता है, वो बाकी technical light camera भी manage कर रहा होता है. तो उस वक्त आप दो तीन आदमी होते हैं,
मल्टीटास्किंग.
यस, तो वो बड़ा यौगिक काम है. इवन आफ्टर कट भी हम भले बातें कर रहे हों, बट एक इनर फोकस है ना, वो रहता है.
करेक्ट,
कि बाबा हम क्या सीन कर रहे थे, तो इनर फोकस हम नहीं खोते हैं.
What's been the hardest skill that you've had to acquire for a role?
For a role?
Couple of them for me. One is like picking up a 90 kg girl when you were 67.
Right.
Yep. So I behaved like a coolie. Sharad Kattari ne, my trainer ne mujhe bola tha ki aap coolie ko dekho. 60 kilo ka ek patla aadmi itna sara bojha utha kar chalta hai, aadat hai usko. So my trainer usko uthata tha main, roz bhagta tha. He was 85 that time, my trainer. I was 65. So it's just habit. Second one was learning the piano from the scratch. It was really difficult. Just devoting 6 hours a day for 3 months, that was the toughest part.
The rest of you?
For me, it was for Uri. I mean, it was majorly physical, but those 2-3 months of military training and boot camp training, very, very tough. It was very tough. And it when shows, military people train you.
Boot camp, brother.
Yeah. It was brutal. It was brutal. And plus, I had to gain weight, which is very tough for me. It's a beautiful, beautiful problem that I have. But
that's
it is very
difficult.
but at the same time, you are doing boot camp training for 3 hours in a day, and then because that will make you lose weight. And plus, you have to gain weight like 15 kilos for that part.
those 3-4 months were really, really tough on me.
I know, I'm still waiting for that toughest thing. I've done extreme things which people think is extreme probably, like, but I think it's for the part. You can't say
no, but in retrospect you feel it's okay, but at that time if you've...
Yeah, like, of course, I haven't done like such extreme physical training, which I'm sure is pretty tough. But for me, it's internal actually. Mm. Like for me, like a trap on an omerta, I would say was pretty tough. Mm. Like for shaving my head half for Bose, it's the most easiest thing. Sit on the chair, Alim Bhai will cut your hair. But probably people will say, wow, what am I an actor. But for me, it's not that. It's like, I will do it for my part. It's my job as an actor. I'm not doing anything extraordinary about that. It's for me, when your psyche changes, that I find very like, wow. That wow moment happens when, you know, you start feeling, even off screen, you start feeling, fuck, I'm sorry. I'm still thinking
it's
about...
It's the third time you've said that. It's okay.
Really? Okay. Yeah. I'm still, you know, living that...
Moment mein rehta nahi hai. Pata nahi ki
kya camera hai.
Sahi moment mein fuck bol diya.
That's the... Those are the moments I find amazing, yeah.
Uri is worth it or no? Absolutely. Look at that trailer. Absolutely.
Yeah,
say
man.
It once. Say it for me. Say it.
Kaun sa time?
How's the Josh?
How's the Josh?
How's the Josh? I love that trailer. It is amazing. That's what I want to see.
It's like amazing. How's the Josh is like yummier than Rogan Josh.
Okay.
I love it.
Like,
I love
it. It's a great trailer.
Vicky and I are doing a movie together.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Put it there. I think my warrior training was, all the sword fighting, horse riding, etc. Happened during Bajirao. Yes, it was difficult, but I think the most difficult challenge is just around the corner. January, I'm going to be training to bowl like Kapil Dev.
Oh, yeah.
So that's going to be hard. Yeah. I must tell you this story, okay? I went to Lord's to watch the test match. It rained all day. Mm-hmm. And there was not a single ball bowled. I was just sitting from morning to evening drinking Pimm's, hoping for one ball.
That's just another test match in Lord's.
So, in the box, Sachin Tendulkar happened to come. And I was lucky enough to get some time with him. And I was telling him, I'm doing this movie and I'm playing Kapil Dev. And he was like, and I was like, sir, I think, you know, I'm going to do all the homework and I'm going to get the look and the accent and everything. But I think the most difficult part will be the bowling. And he was like, oh, you are going to do the bowling yourself? And I said, yeah, sir. He was like, oh. He also thinks it's going to be damn tough.
Right.
Every cricketer I've spoken to saying, bro, do you know what you signed up for? Getting Kapil Dev's action, which is probably the most unique bowling action, is going to be quite the task.
When you start prep?
Yeah.
I'm starting prep in January. I have another great story from another cricketer, which I can't tell you on camera. I'll tell you off camera.
Okay. Pankaji?
आप जिस इमोशनल स्टेट में होते हैं शॉट के पहले या घर से आते हैं शूटिंग के लिए होटल से आते हैं और पता चला वहाँ आके आपको सीन में कुछ और रिक्वायरमेंट है तो उस इमोशनल स्टेट को चेंज करना आपकी ज़िंदगी में कुछ और चल रहा है सीन में कुछ और करना है तो वो भी एक टास्क है कि हमें अपनी ज़िंदगी के मुसीबतों को ख़त्म करना है और सीन की मुसीबतों में जाना है
मुझे
याद है
Yes.
You know, I can share it. It's quite emotional for me.
Like,
Newton, we were shooting and my mother passed away. Yeah. Mm. And I know me being an actor was her biggest happiness in life. So I thought, and I told these guys, you know, I would come back in a day. And they thought he won't be able to come back. But I did my rights. I came back. And I thought I would manage. And I still remember, like, camera used to roll. And these guys would be in front of me and I would be crying. It just, I like, oh no, my mother is watching, I have to perform. And then I think that those probably 10 days were, man. I didn't realize it would have been.
But she blessed you, yeah? Last year was unbelievable.
Yeah. So that was probably the most.
याद है मैं एक दिन रात में मैं राज के कमरे में गया उस वक्त और हम लोग चुप बैठे थे 3-4 मिनट और कुछ हुआ और एक दूसरे को हग कर लिया और 2 मिनट तक ये रोते रहा मैं भी रोते रहा मैं चुप तो मुझे वो नाइट याद है
It is, yeah, of course, it's very difficult. Even like with me, like I was promoting both my films, got to know about my wife's cancer, and I had to just be happy in front of the camera, promote my films. It was the toughest. Like, life is a great leveler. Kuch milta hai, kuch chale jata hai. It's always like that.
What performance did you last watch that made you feel small and inconsequential? That made you go, wow, I could never do that?
No, not I could never do that. Probably I want to do that.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah, that's, I would, always, I want to,
that's always the emotion a little bit.
I think with me, it happened during Star is Born.
Oh, I was Bradley just going to say
Cooper
that.
I was did just in Star is Born, and like, can I say fuck again?
Absolutely.
Like, oh my God.
Yeah.
What the hell? Like, how this guy can, you know, do direction, producing, music, lyrics, singing, and acting at the same time and still do this magic. It was just, wow, overwhelming.
Yeah. My answer is exactly the same.
Blew your mind?
Absolutely. My favorite film of the year.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
I thought La La Land because he was playing piano and I thought it got inspired by him, but at the same time, let's come back to India. I think what Tiger Shroff does, he's such an acrobat.
Bro,
main dekhta kya kar raha hai woh. Aaj tak nahi kar sakta. Bhai,
if this was Coffee with Karan, this response would get the Audi.
The Audi.
I feel ya.
Dude.
I feel you. He's a wonder kid. He's a wonder kid.
He is.
Sure.
Yeah.
It happens to me when I watch Daniel Day-Lewis perform. Mm. I'm like, man.
Every time.
Yeah. Like, you watch There Will Be Blood and stuff. Like, you know, it's just like, man. Chhod de yaar.
I was the saddest when he said, you know, he's not gonna act. Yeah. Like, come on. Yeah. 10 more years probably, yeah.
But Phantom Thread, what a way to go.
That's the last. That's the thing, yeah. When I see non-actors, like Tithi. जैसे उसमें कोर्ट
जी
तो ये कौन लोग हैं कोर्ट में वो एक लेडी है जो आती है कोर्ट में बोलने की मेरे पति के साथ ऐसा हुआ मैंने उसके बाद कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर को खोजा बात किया कि वो महिला कौन है यार मुझे बताओ तो पता चला उनके साथ रियल घटना हुआ था और उनको बुला के करवाया गया तो मुझे हमेशा नॉन एक्ट्रेस ना बहुत प्रभावित करते हैं कि यार ये इवन ड्यूरिंग द न्यूटन जब लोग आए जो एक्टर लोग थे वोटर हमने देखी उनकी ट्रूथ तो लगा बाबा हम तो पकड़े जाएंगे इनके सामने
जी, 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 yeah.
क्या बड़ी बात की आपने यार
ये बड़ी बातें कर रहे हैं बिगनिंग से बड़ी बड़ी बातें कर रहे
हैं
बैठना पड़ेगा विस्की लेकर इनके साथ
नागराज पुरे ने सैराट में यार दोनों ने ऐसे लग रहा सब कुछ आपके सामने ही हो रहा है हम क्या कर रहे हैं कुछ करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं वो ऐसी
इवन अभी एक तमिल फिल्म देखी मैं गोवा में फिल्म फेस्ट में और मैं एक एक्टर को देखा मेरी वाइफ थी और उसने बोला कि यार ये बहुत ब्रिलियंट है मैं बोला सोनू ये ना सिर्फ इस किरदार में ब्रिलियंट है दूसरे रोल में नहीं होंगे ब्रिलियंट एंड आई हैव नो आइडिया कि वो ट्रेंड एक्टर हैं फिल्म खत्म हुआ पता चला वो थे थिएटर में प्रियंका की फिल्म थी कमल जी की वाइफ थी तो मैं मिला उनसे और बाद में पता चला 76 के नेशनल स्कूल ऑफ ड्रामा के वो पास आउट हैं मैं सकते में आ गया कि यार मुझे लग रहा था नॉन एक्टर हैं ये क्या काम किया था उस फिल्म में एक सिक्योरिटी गार्ड
बने एक एक्टर को नॉन एक्टर बनने बहुत बड़ी बात है
हां मतलब आप उनको लगे कि नॉन एक्टर हैं मैं बोला कर मेरी जजमेंट गलत है मुझे कुछ पता नहीं है
दैट काइंड ऑफ अनकलर्ड यू नो वे ऑफ बीइंग इज जस्ट इट्स मैचलेस प्राइसलेस
यू नो आई स्पोक टू अ फ्यू प्रोड्यूसर्स रिसेंटली एंड दे ऑल एग्रीड दैट समथिंग हैज फंडामेंटली चेंज्ड इन द बिजनेस वी ऑल एक्नॉलेज्ड दैट द ऑडियंस इज रिस्पोंडिंग टू स्क्रिप्ट्स एंड ग्रेट स्टोरीज एंड ग्रेट आइडियाज एंड ग्रेट कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड दैट वर्ड दैट आई रियली डोंट लाइक वेरी मच कॉन्टेंट
इज
इंडीड किंग बट इट्स मोर देन दैट इजंट इट इवन टेफ्लॉन स्टार्स लाइक सलमान एंड शाहरुख एंड आमिर व्हेन देयर मूवीज हैवंट हेल्ड अप दे फेल्ड रेस 3 जब हैरी मेट सेजल लास्ट ईयर Thugs of Hindustan most recently, these films were supposed to be a sure thing. Mm. But it feels like there is no such thing as a sure thing anymore. What are your biggest learnings from the last year or so?
I think great time to be an actor.
Yeah.
And great time to explore. And because there is definitely an audience. There are definitely wonderful filmmakers. And definitely people who are there to, you know, have that faith in you now.
I think not just... An actor, great time to be any creative person, director,
writer.
Producer, writer, cameraman, anybody. It's become so secular, it's only talent driven or whatever that word you like, content driven. But I guess it's just that you have to keep the script above you. Jis din aap sochne lage ki aap script se upar hain, tab thoda sa problem ho sakti hai. But I think you should always keep the script above you.
कहानी से बड़ी कुछ
कुछ नहीं
कुछ नहीं है. सब कहानी का खेल है. और सर इसकी क्रेडिट जो है ना ऑडियंस को जाता है कि सिर्फ हम फिल्म मेकर से स्टोरी टेलर डेवलप में ग्रो नहीं हुए हैं, ऑडियंस हमारी ग्रो हुई है कि नाउ दे नो कि यार सिनेमा ऐसे ऐसे भी होते हैं. तो उस उनका योगदान है.
बिल्कुल सर, आयुष्मान खुराना ने बोल दिया,
हो गई बात.
बात सीखो तो कोई इनसे सीखो भाई. जितना आर ओ आई यहाँ से आया है इस साल. But it's true. It's testament to the evolution of the audience. As my mentor Adi Chopra said, "Sir, chadkar bol rahi hai audience. They don't care who's in the film. You know, they are, if you have a good story to tell, if your content is quality, they will come and watch and applaud. And they will, no matter how big your mounting is, if it's no good, they're going to reject it.
Yeah.
Absolutely." True. A lot of actors, when they're playing negative characters, they say that they don't think of them as villains. The character might be a villain to the on the outside. It might be someone that we view as a bad guy, but you don't think of them as villains when you're actually playing that part. They seek out the humanity. They try to understand why he is the way that he is. Ranveer, the role of Khilji was always meant to be a villain. He's all black. There's no gray. He's meant to be this cruel, selfish embodiment of all evil. Is that how you saw him?
Yes, throughout, from start to finish, throughout the process, I found it immensely difficult to not pay heed and attention to Ranveer's own moral barometer that was saying Khilji is a bad man. You know, I had to. It was imperative before I start performing this character to transport myself to a place where I had to believe in his reality. You know, I had to believe in what he, in what his worldview was. I had to align to that. That in his world, what he's doing, his absolute, you know, self-centeredness, self-absorption is what he believes is right. And from his perspective, he's doing what's right and what works for him. You know, when I was performing, I definitely did that. And I think the reason that character is the villain of the film, you know, at every level. But I think the reason it was perhaps the reason it was effective and that it resonated is because there was a tremendous amount of honesty in the bad that he was doing. You know, he was very committed to his cruelty. Right. And I think that's perhaps what resonated.
Raj, for you, how did you view Omar Syed Sheikh, the character that you played in Omarta? He's of course a cold-blooded terrorist. He had connections with Osama bin Laden and in 9/11, he killed innocent people. Is that the way you viewed him, as a bad guy, as a villain?
No, I echo what he said. I think I totally agree that as Raj, I can't, you know, put my theories in that. When you're playing a character like Omar, has his own reasonings. Probably as layman, we would say it's wrong. It's unethical. But for him, what he's doing is right. He believes in his ideologies. He's doing it for a reason, and he strongly supports his cause or his organization's cause, which, as Raj, of course, now I can say, of course, it is wrong. It is definitely wrong what they are doing, but he believed in it, and that's how I saw it. I said, if I have to play it, I can't, you know, go half-heartedly. I have to believe in those convictions. I have to tell myself, this is how I see the world. This is how I want to be the world. I want the world to be. You know, I don't want to, of course, go into a religious angle of it. It's not religious. Now, as Raj, I think it's not even religious. It's just people are badly brainwashed. They're so strongly brainwashed that they don't see anything else.
And that's what the film is about as well, right? Yeah. The making of a terrorist.
Making of a terrorist. Right. That like how I start preparing for it, I started reading a lot of, you know, books about organizations. I started hearing a lot of speeches. Speeches which were full of hatred and anger. And seeing those images, brutal images. Just to cultivate that anger inside me, to cultivate that hatred against people inside me. And that really helped me. I started seeing everybody as an enemy. That, you know, why is this guy in front of me? He's not supposed to be here. No, I'm going to take revenge for all my brothers and sisters. And what's happening is, whatever happened is wrong. I need to take things in my hand now. And then you can't think that, you know, no, it's not right, but I shouldn't say this. You have to go full on.
Yeah. May I just...
Yeah.
During that process, did it spill over to
to you off camera?
It did.
It did, didn't
I'll
it?
Spoken about
it. Yeah. It did. I start feeling this like, you know, this venom towards people, and it scares me because I'm not like that at all.
Right.
Yeah.
But you don't know when the lines blur if you're far deep down that rabbit hole.
You know, I used to watch BBC a lot for the accent and all, or like 5:30, 5 a.m. in the morning. I was in my hotel room and Paris attacks just happened. Mm. And I was in the middle of shooting, so I was mentally there. You know, first thought that came to my mind was, well done.
Oh my God.
What are you saying?
That's some serious.
Oh,
that's some serious.
And then, of course, the fight between Raj is like, no, fuck, no. It's not well done.
Third
it's wrong. Yeah. It's wrong.
That's wrong. Well done. It happened to me also. Yeah. I'm on set, and this is like when the camera's not rolling. And somebody does something that grinds my gears or pushes the wrong button, and I was going to physically attack them. Yeah. I was going to go grab his throat, and I was like, "Wait, what are you doing? It's damn scary."
But it's amazing.
Sun rahe tu?
All set to play a farce.
Yeah.
Aurangzeb, no less.
It's just that, you know, I've never played an out and out dark character.
Right.
But one thing is that I've never taken the character back home.
Hmm.
But it'll be really interesting. At the same time, during college days, I've played Ashwathama, which is like a dark character, grey character in Dharamveer Bharati Zanda Yoga, is a famous play.
Yeah.
But nobody could expect like an out and out negative character out of me. But I've mostly played negative characters in my college theatre.
Mm.
So I've yet to explore that side of mine in front of the camera. But I've never taken the character back home. I can switch on and switch off like that. It's just like that. I'd be joking. Both Tabu and I used to joke around while we were filming Andhadhun, and then we were just
going and doing those things.
Yeah, gruesome.
You know, there's a popular opinion that some of the best art comes from a place of fear and doubt and conflict. That there needs to be discomfort for great art to come out of a person or to be created from inside a person. Is there some truth to that from your own experiences? Have you found that perhaps your best work comes when you are in a place of discomfort?
Because you say now, chup se chup baitha tha, bol.
Or is it again one of those romantic notions, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm not that experienced, or maybe I have not experienced that. But I don't know. I've always felt that I felt in sync with the character when I'm like I'm in harmony with myself.
Hmm.
In fact, quite the opposite.
So it's the opposite, right?
Hmm? Till now, it might happen.
Sure.
But till now, I don't know if I've felt that.
Ranveer, you made 3 movies with Mr. Bansali, who is a tough taskmaster. Does some of the best work come because...
Rajiv, why are you putting me on the spot? I want to do more movies with him, man. That is a widely believed notion about Mr. Bansali, that he'll put your back against the wall and throw you in the deep end.
It's not entirely untrue.
Not in my case. We have a very evolved relationship, director-actor dynamic over 3 films. So not necessarily, not anymore. But sometimes you want to throw a person in the deep end. When they perform or operate out of a life and death, instinct, something else will come out. And I've witnessed it, so I can vouch for it. But my personal belief is that it's not necessary.
I think it's a very fantastical or maybe philosophical as a viewpoint. Like a lot of people say the art emanates out of conflict.
Correct.
Or whatever. Jab tak dil nahi tootega to likhega kaise? I think it's bullshit. I think I agree with Vicky in that there has to be harmony.
Mm.
An artist needs to be happy. Happiness gives you everything. Gives you confidence. Gives you great... art coming from inside. I think it's there. Artist needs to be in that perfect harmony, in that sync with the universe.
Sir, wo main sahmat bhi hoon inki baat se aur asahmat bhi hoon.
Ji.
Jab crisis mein mulk hota hai na, society hoti hai na, wahan bahut badhiya writing hota hai. क्योंकि राइटर को लगता है कि यार ये तो कई बार वो राइटिंग की बात कर रहे हैं, सेम टाइम पेंटिंग की भी बात हो सकती है.
करेक्ट. इट इंस्पायर्स द बेस्ट आर्ट.
हाँ, कि जब क्राइसिस में मुल्क होता है, सोसाइटी होता है, तो बहुत अच्छी अच्छी आर्ट क्रिएट होती हैं. सेम टाइम अभिनेता ना, आप खुशी में होंगे, आप अच्छी स्थिति में, जो अभी बोल रहे थे आयुष्मान, बट आपको एक सीन में ना अपने आप को डालते हैं हम कॉम्प्लेक्स में कि बाबा हम तो बड़े, जैसे शुरुआत में हमने बात कही थी कि आप जिस मेंटल स्टेट में घर से आते हैं या इमोशनल स्टेट में यहाँ आपको चेंज करना है, तो कई बार हम अपने आप को डालते हैं उस हालात में कि यार हमारे लाइफ में तो सब ठीक चल रहा है, अब आज इस रोल की रिक्वायरमेंट तो कुछ ऐसी है तो क्या करें, तो सुबह से हम नकली कहानी गढ़ रहे होते हैं कि यार मेरे साथ ऐसा हो जाए तो क्या होगा, आप अपने आप को हैप्पी जोन से उस क्राइसिस में डाल रहे हो, तो वही है मेडिटेशन है सर, अध्यात्म है, सब साधु बैठे हैं।
शिव कुमार बटालवी ने कहा था कि आर्टिस्ट जो है ना, जो थिंकर है, वो फरार चाहता है, और कभी फरार चाहने के चक्कर में ना कि आप जो सोसाइटी का जो समाज में चल रहा है उसे दूर भागना चाहते हैं, पर एट द सेम टाइम कहना चाहते हैं अपने आर्ट के जरिए, आप शायद एक हार्मनी में होंगे, आपके देश में कुछ और चल रहा होगा, तो उसके चक्कर में आप कुछ ऐसा दे देंगे समाज को कि बहुत अलग होगा,
बहुत अलग होगा।
आई थिंक आई हैव एन एग्जांपल लाइक हंसल सर, व्हेन ही वाज मेकिंग शाहिद, ही वाज कमिंग आउट ऑफ अ यू नो लाइक आफ्टर 3 years ही वाज प्लानिंग अ फिल्म, एंड ऑफ कोर्स ही वाज नॉट वेरी हैप्पी विद द सोनोग्राफी बिफोर दैट, सो ही केम विद दैट डिस्कम्फर्ट, ही केम विद दैट फायर, आई थिंक दैट इन अ वे ट्रांसलेटेड इन दैट फिल्म, सो इट समटाइम्स इट हेल्प्स, आई थिंक या यू इट इट मोटिवेट्स यू इनफ to, you know, just to probably get out of that synergy of your own self that, you know, I won't translate it in my work. Yeah, it can help sometimes.
But depending on that will be quite lethal. Like completely depending on conflicts.
Correct.
And that inner craziness.
Yeah.
I'm so scared now in my next movie, Mr. Bhansali is going to be like, Aba, beta.
Maine round table dekha.
Bada round table pe baith raha hai tu.
What was your first reaction when the Me Too movement began gathering momentum in India recently? A lot of women came out with their stories of being uncomfortable, being harassed, being made to feel uncomfortable. What went through your mind at the time?
I think it's the need of the hour.
Yeah.
We've been living in patriarchal society since time immemorial. This is 2018 ending, 2019 is beginning. Yeah. It's high time there should be gender parity. It takes a lot for a woman to come out in the open and stand up for her rights, or maybe pinpoint at a certain perpetrator. So, of course, there'll be collateral damage. But at the same time, I think equal opportunity should be given to both the parties to prove their innocence. But I think this should happen. We need that environment for women to survive, to be themselves. And it should be in every organization to have do's and don'ts, especially in our industry. It's everywhere, not just in our industry.
Mm-hmm. Right.
It should be safe during the outdoors, everywhere.
No, more power to these women. Sure. I think it was, as he rightly said, it was the need of the hour. I think we needed these women to come out. You know, a lot of people say it's now, of course, definitely the way we work probably will definitely change and women will feel more safer.
Mm.
And that's what we want, not only in our industry. I think as a country, that's what we want, you know, our women to feel safe and protected.
And not be taken for granted.
Yeah, not be taken for granted. And these powerful men, not to take them for granted.
Mm. Right.
That, you know, I have that power, I can use it and do whatever I want. Now you can't.
Yeah.
Thanks to social media, now you can't.
I thought it was historic.
Mm.
When it first exploded, the first few days, it was surreal. I couldn't believe what was happening. I was like this, and I was the first to voice it to the people around me. I was like, do you guys see what's happening? And this, what's happening, is historic. It's unprecedented. It's never happened before. And it led to a purge, a much, much needed purge.
Yeah.
You know, those who had done these despicable things for too long were taken to task, punished.
Right, there have been some repercussions, yeah.
Yeah, and I think it's superb. Because at the ground level, I can tell you there's been a change.
Yeah.
Ab mardon ki phatti hai, you know. They will think twice. Because, like you said, the power of social media, it offers a platform for you to get that justice. Mm. Yes, there is collateral damage as well. But this is what happens when there is a revolution. There is collateral damage.
Yeah.
You know, it is nothing short of a historic revolution. And I think it's mind-blowing.
देखिए पंकज जी,
यस यस, बिल्कुल एग्रीड हैं सारी बातों से, बहुत जरूरी है और उन्हें ताकत और मिलनी चाहिए हर फील्ड में, नॉट सिर्फ सिनेमा इंडस्ट्री में, इंटायर जितने सेक्टर हैं सब में.
एंड इट टेक्स, इफ यू बीन वायलेटेड मैन, इट टेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ करेज टू स्टैंड अप, स्पेशली टू कम आउट विद योर आइडेंटिटी एंड से दिस हैपेंड टू मी एंड इट वाज रॉन्ग, यू नो, इट टेक्स it takes a mountain of courage. Yeah. And you have to respect that, you have to support that. You can't be insensitive to that.
Hmm. Was there a moment when you introspected and asked yourselves whether you might have acted or spoken or done something to make someone feel uncomfortable or to behave inappropriately? I ask because women have said repeatedly that most men don't even realize what is inappropriate behavior.
Yeah.
I mean, was there a moment of just introspection?
Of course, it's natural.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
But the lines are blurred, right?
True.
I'm not doing it out of malice or anything, but of course I'm thinking where the line is. Where the line is for me, maybe it's not where the line is for her.
Yeah.
You know. So it's relative. You know, it's very subjective, and that's the complexity of it.
And you believe that things have and will change?
Things have changed.
Drastically. Also depends on your upbringing, I think, how women have been treated in your family.
Right.
Mm. Yeah.
You know, cinema has been the dominant form of entertainment in this country for years. But some say that dominance is being challenged now. Netflix and Amazon and all of these great digital and OTT platforms are really leading this change. One just has to look at outdoor advertising to see the kind of budgets that some of these shows have. Yeah. They're great shows. I mean, Sacred
Mowgli
Games.
Just released today.
And that's right. Sacred Games, Mirzapur, two really great shows, both of which Mr. Tripathi's in.
Yeah, yeah.
Big filmmakers are working in these formats. What's the sense
Highway
that
pe
you
jao.
Get?
Highway pe jao, Bandra se gore gao, to bas Pankaj saab hai, kya baat?
And he's so good in them. Yeah. Mirzapur especially, Gurgaon, he's just, man. That's true.
Gurgaon dekhe ho kya?
Aray sir, humare Shankar Amar humare khas
hai. Aray, kya adbhut aadmi hai, wo sant hai.
Adbhut aadmi hai, aap hai.
But what's the sense that you get? Is cinema under threat?
It's high time, no? Because you're taking your position for granted that you're the only source of entertainment and recreation. Now the onus is all the more on the creators that now the newer generation has access to content from all over the world.
Yeah.
You know, and they, if you're not good, they are not going to see you. So you had better pull up your socks and work harder and not take these things for granted.
Yeah.
And I think it's a great thing. It's, you know, it's also at the most significantly, it offers avenues, man, and for creative people. And right. That's so important for actors, for writers. And because it's not a theatrical medium, it's also very creatively empowering, you know, so you can explore more. You're not shackled.
Yes.
So I think it's superb.
Also, just that pressure to not have to, taking away that pressure of opening day numbers, opening weekend numbers. I mean, you had two films that were on straight to Netflix and great responses to both.
Yeah, yeah.
It does take away that pressure. That is for sure.
Definitely.
And I think, as he said, I think it's very important now for, you know, filmmakers and all of us to pull up our socks and offer something new and interesting for people to actually pay money and come out to theaters and watch our films. Mm. I'm glad it happened, you know, this year, and you know, we had some really high concept and content driven film that people saw. I hope it just continues, because Netflix, of course, there's a parallel industry running and it will definitely grow from here.
Mm.
But I think cinema will survive probably for next 10-15 years.
It's a revolution which is happening right now. It's a revolution. Obviously, digital medium has that leeway. They can go rad. The censorships are lenient.
Mm.
They can be more edgy.
That might
wacky.
Change, though, unfortunately.
Don't say
that. Oh, yeah.
No. I read something that I might.
But at the same time, I think if you are paying money, buying a ticket, you have to give certain content which is completely novel, crazy, out of the box, if you have to go to the cinemas. But at the same time, it's just like, you know, watching the film with a lot of people around.
Yeah.
It's like
exactly like watching
a cricket match in the stadium.
Correct.
Or on television. So cinema viewing will never go out of fashion.
बिल्कुल सर वो experience जो है ना समूह में देखने का community viewing का
yeah.
cinema कहीं ना कहीं एक बड़ा class break भी करता है.
Correct.
बिल्कुल.
It's the leveler.
Factory का मालिक बैठा है इस कुर्सी पे बाजू वाले कुर्सी पे दूसरे factory का मजदूर बैठा है और दोनों साथ में मजे ले रहे हैं
पॉपकॉर्न लेने जा रहे हो
हाँ तो
आती
वो individual viewing में वो मजा नहीं है जो हम समूह में हंसते हैं और हमारा क्लास टूट जाता है
and also what happens with me is every time I sit in a cinema hall with my popcorn and just the first slate of the production house and I'm like man this is what I live for you know that feeling that I get You know, it's just, I don't know, I can't compare that with any other platform without demeaning any other platform, but the feel that I get, the
I literally get transported. You know, I feel in that dark hole, I literally feel like it's a different world. It's I'm just indulging.
But do you get better opportunities as an actor? Do you find that there are better opportunities?
हाँ यस ऑफ कोर्स डिजिटल में हाँ हाँ क्योंकि एक तो वहाँ लेंथ है ना सर आप कैरेक्टर के बतौर एक्टर डेफ्थ में जा सकते हो राइटर भी जा सकता है क्योंकि हमें 9 घंटे कहने हैं तो एक्सपेरिमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ डेप्थ हम ज़्यादा जा सकते हैं कि और लेयर्स क्या हो सकते हैं वहाँ 2-2.5 घंटे में कहानी
कहनी इंडल्जेंस हर एक के लिए हो सकती है वहाँ पर एक्टर के लिए डायरेक्टर के लिए
सारे सारे डिपार्टमेंट के लिए
क्योंकि ऑडियंस के लिए भी अच्छा चलो ठीक है खाना खा के वापस आके देख लेंगे सो इट्स लाइक एवरीवेयर एंड दिस इज द बेस्ट एरा टू बी एन आर्टिस्ट एज आई सेड
करेक्ट
एक्टर डायरेक्टर प्रोड्यूसर एवरीवेयर
I thought I'd end by asking you, you know, biopics are all the rage right now. Mm. Yeah. If you could pick the one character that you could play in history.
Kishore Kumar.
Yeah?
Dying to play Kishore Kumar. Seriously, could sing my own songs.
You're already a singer.
Yeah, 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 yeah. And that, he as a character was so versatile. Actor, singer, producer, music director. He could do everything. Harfan Maula, jise bolte hain. So, would love to play Kishore Kumar.
Anurag Basu sahab, ye lijiye.
Correct.
आपका किशोर कुमार तैयार है
क्या फील्डिंग की है तू
अरे यार दो साल से कर रहा हूँ फील्डिंग में बैटिंग करने का मन कर रहा है मेरा
करेगा तू करेगा इंशाल्लाह करेगा
राज विकी पंकज सिंह
चाइल्डहुड आई थिंक आई वाज वेरी अमेज्ड बाय भगत सिंह या बिकॉज़ ऑफ कोर्स वी बीन वाचिंग भगत सिंह सिंस फॉरएवर सिन मनोज साहब्स टाइम So I could connect with this passion, and I want to play him very differently. Like you know, like I've seen pictures of him in like in books and like real pictures. So I want to. I would
and there have been movies made as well.
Yeah, they have been, and great movies also. True. Like Ajay Sir was amazing as Legend of Bhagat Singh, but I want to like give it a different probably. So I would love to play Bhagat Singh.
I'm getting to play a part, which I'm very excited for.
Aurangzeb.
But apart from that, I've always been very fascinated with the life of Guru Dutt.
Right.
Because I felt like the way he romanced with sadness, it's just, I don't know, it's a different emotion I feel and I really want to explore that emotion.
Yeah.
I literally feel that he really enjoyed it. He really cherished it and I don't know why, he just wanted to be there. And that's what I want to explore, just that emotion, just that world. And I've been very fascinated. So I guess, I mean, this question just, sure. this name just popped up.
मैं जो करना चाहता था वो अभी कर दिया
अच्छा
6 दिन पहले
वाह क्या
वाह
बताओ
मैं एक बहुत ही कॉमन मैन की बायोपिक करना चाहता था बहुत ही ऑर्डिनरी आदमी का जिसका मतलब कुछ नहीं है तो वो सतीश जी की फिल्म सतीश कौशिक जी की वो हम 6 दिन पहले खत्म कर लिए
अच्छा
बहुत ही सिंपल आम आदमी की कहानी
सुपर स्टोरी है सर
बट स्टोरी बहुत ब्रिलियंट है राज को पता है वो हमने अभी पूरी कर ली
अरे वाह
अंकज जी
सब बहुत मजा आया
बहुत खुश नसीब हैं आप
हां अरे नहीं अभी तो और बहुत बचे हुए हैं सपने
लेकिन जो भी
सब
ही फील्डिंग कर रहे हैं कोई लॉन्ग ऑन पे फील्डिंग कर रहे हैं तो कोई लॉन्ग ऑफ पे फील्डिंग
कर रहे हैं तो बोलेंगे आप तो
करने का बिल देंगे याद आया बायोपिक मैं कर रहा हूं जी जनवरी में मेरी ट्रेनिंग है
ट्रेनिंग
पाजी का रोल कर रहा है इट्स वियर्ड वन आई थिंक आई हैड वन मूवी आउट एंड समबडी आस्क्ड मी इन 2011 लाइक व्हाट पार्ट वुड यू वांट टू प्ले एंड आई वाज लाइक कपिल देव एंड आई डिडंट इवन रियलाइज देयर वाज नो लाइक माइंड टू थिंक कनेक्ट इट जस्ट केम आउट इंस्टिंक्टिवली सो आई थिंक देयर सम एंड देन द मूवी वाज ऑफर्ड टू मी लाइक 7 इयर्स लेटर सो आई थिंक इट्स सम There's some divinity there. But yeah, there is Dara Shikho as well. I enjoy that. I enjoy those roles, you know.
How wonderful that your dreams are already, in fact, starting to come true.
Yeah.
Thank you for these incredible performances that you've given us. You know, here's hoping that you will continue to inspire us and entertain us and really give us the good time that we get. Thank you for bringing joy into our lives with these really wonderful, nuanced performances, giving us characters that have stayed with us long after we've left the cinemas. Thank you for raising the bar. Looking forward to lots more.
Thank you.
Cheers, gentlemen.
Cheers.